Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Consumption of both fish and animal flesh continue and are wreaking havoc on biodiversity around the globe. In the oceans and freshwaterways, so many species of fish have already been lost, with complete aquatic environments such as coral reefs being decimated by such practices as trawling and fishing with explosives.
Supreme Master Ching Hai, vegan, on the harmful effects of meat, part 14, Destroying Our Oceans. Continue watching to find out more.
Здравствуйте, жизнерадостные зрители, means hello, cheerful viewers in Russian, one of the official languages of the Karachaево-Cherkassia Republic. I am Yuri. The virtuous citizens of the Karachaево-Cherkassia Republic wish that your kindness and love to others reward you with good health and blessings. Warning, you might find the content herein disturbing, but the truth must be revealed. In our modern era, we are increasingly plagued by pandemics, chronic diseases, rising temperatures, intensified natural disasters, and environmental degradation, a planet in crisis. If we look closely, all these devastating issues can be traced back to the human habit of meat eating. The time has come to turn away from what was long accepted as the norm and fully examine meat's impacts on our health and the environment, as well as our moral and spiritual development. Over the years, Supreme Master Ching Hai has shared her insights about the harmful effects of meat on many different occasions. In this series, we present a collection of Master's enlightening teachings on this very topic and pray that humanity will soon awaken and embrace the vegan diet so that we and future generations may live on and in a more harmonious world. Our planet is facing an ecological collapse, not only on land, but also in the oceans. Scientists warn that global warming is causing abrupt ecological disruption. Moreover, human fishing is rapidly depleting oceans and endangering marine species. The delicate balance of ocean ecosystems is being jeopardized by human activities. Supreme Master Ching Hai has been raising public awareness on this matter, hoping to inspire change.
Fish eating also very depleting to planetary ecosystem. They have proven that the overfishing of sardine has resulted in many dead zones because they are there for some reason. They are there for the ocean, give life to some other kind of species or cleaning the environment, whatever the species that God has left on the planet. They have a work to do. The species have work to do. Just like human, we have work to do. Animals, they have work to do. Even little fish like sardine, they have work to do. It's just many humans are ignorant. They think they're just a little fish. They're helpless anyway, useless. No, they are not useless. So they think they're useless, so they fish them up and eat them. But they are very, very useful to our ecosystem and to the health of the planet and consequently to the health of human and all beings on it. If we say that the ocean ecosystems are dependent on fish populations to be balanced, then those ecosystems are extremely imbalanced right now. Scientists estimate that more than 90% of the ocean's big fish have disappeared over the last 50 years due to commercial fishing. They warned that at the present rate of fishing, there will be a global collapse of all species being fished by 2050, and say that recovery efforts need to be started immediately. Meat consumption has a huge destructive impact on biodiversity, which is essential for our Earth to function and thus must be preserved. No matter how small, each species has a role to help balance our ecosystem, scientifically proven. And yet, consumption of both fish and animal flesh continue and are wreaking havoc on biodiversity around the globe. In the oceans and fresh waterways, so many species of fish have already been lost, with complete aquatic environments such as coral reefs being decimated by such practices as trawling and fishing with explosives. If fish are continually taken from the ocean, it will become as empty as the desert. In 2006, an international team of scientists and economists found that around a third of the ocean's fish populations has already been wiped out due to fishing, pollution, and other human causes. They warned that if the steep decline of fish population was not stopped, the oceans would be empty of fish by 2048. It's not far future for us. Our own survival is at risk if we continue consuming fish, because the oceans produce half of the world's oxygen, and fish are an important part of the marine ecosystem, which produces oxygen for us. Whales, you know, the big giant gentle fishes in the sea, they are savers of our world, savers of oxygen. They keep CO2 in them for a long, long time, and they produce oxygen for our world. Imagine that. And still some people are hunting them for food, making excuses such as scientific research. What do we have to do any research with the fish who has existed, I mean, hundreds of thousands of years in the sea? If we don't touch them, we leave them alone. God takes care of them.
Loving viewers, we pause for a moment to listen to an important message. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. Welcome back to our program. Contrary to what many believe, fish have intelligence, understanding, and can even sense positive energy. Supreme Master Qinghai shared one of her own interesting encounters with fish and explained why fish love to be close to spiritual practitioners.
一洗下去啊，一来啊，然后碰到水洗脸嘛，我是大家洗手啊，鱼啊马上飘上来，哇，飘到整个湖都亮了，每次都一样。鱼也很喜欢靠近我们，它懂，它那个里面的那个佛心的懂啊，它的佛心和我们的佛心一样，没有这个里面的佛心啊，鱼不能动，我们也不能走路。 不能想，就是鱼它不能想跟我们那么一样啊，因为它的脑部的结构啊，它和我们的脑部的结构都不一样啊，所以它不能想。不过它自己那个
Fish are incredibly intelligent and sensitive. Israeli scientists taught some fish to get food from listening to a particular sound. And after 5 months, they still remember what they learned. Imagine? And this is not to talk about the tremendous invisible benefits these animals could bring to humans' lives and homes, even the fish.
Master, yeah. I'm just wondering, do animals also know the problem of global warming and climate change? Are they doing anything to help us save our beautiful planet? Thank you.
The animals, they know about it, of course. They are trying their best, you know, to sound the warning bell and warning by disease and even death en masse. But I don't know how many of us are listening. Some fish even go on the beach, you know, hundreds of them at the same time and die in there. And so many other signs in the nature, so many animal signs, but we have to listen. It's not the animals. It's us.
Unfortunately, many people today still go fishing as a recreation, unaware that fish are sentient beings just like us.
Was this man für ein Karma auf sich, wenn man Fische angelt? Oh, natürlich, man sieht viel, viel Karma auf sich. Was denkst du, ha? Huh? Oder die Fisch sieht die Karma auf sich auf, oder was?
Natürlich, als wir haben Fische, haben wir viel Karma.
Ah, of course, if you go fishing, then you create, of course, heavy karma because you are terminating a living being when his time has not yet come, when he hasn't gone naturally by God's will. Any time we terminate an existence by our own self-will, we create a burden for our soul. And it's very difficult for us to erase that later on.
Supreme Master Qinghai also dispelled the confusion about whether or not fish is vegetarian and why taking it off our plate along with other animal products is important to achieving lasting world peace.
How do you classify fish? Are those considered meat as well, or is that something okay to eat?
You want to include fish in vegetarian diet, is that right?
I'm just wondering how you...
Well, fish is not vegetable anyhow.
Well, it's not meat either.
It's meat.
Oh, okay.
It's fish meat. It's animal protein. We can't say fish is vegetarian, no? A vegetable, no? It's not. If we truly wish to see real harmony born between humans and animals and nature and heaven, we must be the harmony. We must live in harmony and act also in harmony, which includes the act of eating harmoniously each time we come to the table. Peace, compassion, mercy begin on our plate. We cannot truly call ourselves harmonious if every meal is the result of filling our hands with the blood of the innocent and harming the environment and killing our planet in which we live. How can we call a dinner of fish harmonious when slow and painful deaths by mass suffocation had to take place to bring the fish there on our plate? All the scriptures told us that we receive what we grant, or we reap what we sow.
Peaceful viewers, thank you for joining us on our program today. Supreme Master Qinghai, Vegan on the Harmful Effects of Meat, Part 14, Destroying Our Oceans. Coming up is Shining World Compassion Award recipient Al Larson, the Bluebird Man, right after Noteworthy News. May your heart be filled with boundless love of the Most High.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/show.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule et suprememastertv.com/show.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule y suprememastertv.com/show.
برامجنا متوفرة بالعديد من اللغات. يرجى زيارة suprememastertv.com/schedule و suprememastertv.com/show.